Tonight of all nights, the last night of Black History Month, what may be the worst Black History Month ever. We got blackface, we've got the N-word, we have a call for the return of the KKK. Yes, all of that happened just this month. And listen, it's not a surprise. You don't have to have grown up in the Deep South like I did to know that racism is very much alive in this country. But don't fool yourself. Don't get it twisted. Racist acts are not just a Southern thing, as they say. They're popping up in fashion, in media, and even on Capitol Hill. And right now, the final hours of the worst Black History Month ever, there's more. Tonight, the Maryland House of Delegates unanimously voted to censure one of their own for using the N-word to describe a majority black district. Yep, she went there. Marianne Lasanti, one of the few elected Democrats in the deep red, mostly white county, not only used that hateful word in conversation with other lawmakers last month, she told the Washington Post she didn't remember saying it, and she went on to say this, and this is a quote. I'm sure everyone has used it. I've used the F word. I've used the Lord's name in vain. I almost can't believe that I have to say it again. Well, maybe I can. That is not the same thing. Using the N-word to describe a country or a county where the majority of voters are black is not the same thing as dropping an F-bomb or taking the Lord's name in vain. It's not the same because it is, quite frankly, racist. Lasanti released a statement apologizing, saying she is, quote, sickened that that word came out of her mouth, out of my mouth. That was her quote. It is not in my vocabulary, and it does not represent my belief system, my life's work, or what's in my heart. But she's hardly the only one to use hateful language. She's not even the only one this month. So let me give you an example. There is the publisher of a small local newspaper in Alabama who wrote an editorial calling for the KKK to ride again. Goodloe Sutton wrote that Democrats were planning to raise taxes and then went on to say, quote, seems like the Klan would be welcome to raid the gated communities up there. But he wasn't done there. Nope. Sutton then told the Montgomery Advisor, quote, we'll get the hemp ropes out, loop them over a tall limb, and hang all of them. Well, he lost his job as publisher, replaced by an African-American woman. Alicia R. Dexter is her name. And let's not forget about what has been going on in Virginia, shall we? You remember that, what Governor Ralph Northam said when the scandal broke over his page in his medical school yearbook showing a man in blackface and another in a KKK outfit.
That photo and the racist and offensive attitudes it represents does not reflect that person I am today or the way that I have conducted myself as a soldier, a doctor, and a public servant. I am deeply sorry. I cannot change the decisions I made, nor can I undo the harm my behavior caused then and today.
He said he couldn't change the decisions he made, but less than 24 hours later, he changed his mind about taking responsibility for that photo.
I would remember that, and I have no recollection at all. It's not my picture. I was not in that costume either as black-faced or as KKK.
And this is a tone-deaf defense. It really is, if I've ever heard one. And I'm sure I'm not the guy in the blackface in the yearbook photo. If I wasn't that guy, or if I was, whatever, I would have remembered. I know because I remember putting on blackface that other time, is what he said.
I dressed up in a, what's his name? The singer? Michael Jackson, excuse me. That's why I had Pam with me. I had the shoes, I had a glove, and I used just a little bit of shoe polish to put under my, or on my cheeks. It was a dance contest. I had always liked Michael Jackson. I actually won the contest because I had learned how to do the moonwalk.
Governor Northam is not the only one facing a blackface scandal this month. The number three official in Virginia, the Attorney General, Mark Herring, said he put on a black face for a party in the 1980s when he and his friends dressed like rappers. Herring has apologized. And remember when Governor Northam's wife apparently stopped him from demonstrating his moonwalking skills in that news conference?
Are you still able to moonwalk?
Inappropriate circumstances.
My wife says inappropriate circumstances.
Well, now Pam Northam herself is in the midst of a controversy for reportedly handing out cotton to African-American students on a tour of the governor's mansion and asking them to imagine being slaves in the fields. That is according to a state employee who is the mother of one of the students, an eighth grade girl. Pam Northam said in a statement that she regretted upsetting anyone with what she called an educational tour. And the governor's office insists African-American students were not singled out. It does sound like her intentions were good. She wanted the students to think about the horrors of slavery. But do you have to hold a piece of cotton to do that? And it's not just in politics where people are being tone deaf. Burberry apologized for showing a hoodie with a noose around the neck at a London Fashion Week. Gucci apologized for a sweater that resembled blackface and has promised to promote diversity in their company. Jussie Smollett's job on Empire may be on the line after producers cut his character Jamal Lyons from the final two episodes of the season in the wake of allegations he staged his own hate crime. Chicago Police Superintendent Eddie T. Johnson said this.
Empire actor Jussie Smollett took advantage of the pain and anger of racism to promote his career. I'm left hanging my head and asking why. Why would anyone, especially an African-American man, use the symbolism of a noose to make false accusations?
And of course, there was Congressman Mark Meadows at the Michael Cohen hearing just yesterday, trotting out Lynn Patton, a Trump administration official, as if she were a live prop, in an attempt to prove the president couldn't possibly be a racist.
I asked Lynn to come today in her personal capacity to actually shed some light. How long have you known Ms. Patton?
I'm responsible for Lynn Patton joining the Trump Organization and the job that she currently holds.
Well, I'm glad you acknowledge that, because you made some very demeaning comments about the president that Ms. Patton doesn't agree with. In fact, it has to do with your claim of racism. She says that as a daughter of a man born in Birmingham, Alabama, that there is no way that she would work for an individual who was racist. How do you reconcile the two of those, Mr.
As neither should I, as the son of a Holocaust survivor.
All of that happened this month. This month, Black History Month, a month that proves, as if we couldn't all see it as clear as day, that racism is not just a part of our history, it's not just a part of our past, it is very much alive in America today. It's an important issue, and it's something we all have to reckon with. Will you think about everything I just told you, please, as we move forward?